Hello and welcome to Nikolai's Genetics Lessons, and today's problem is 16% of the individuals in the population have recessive phenotypes. What is the percentage of the heterozygous genotypes? In order to solve this problem, everything we have to know is Hardy-Weinberg formula. So frequency of the three genotypes equal to p squared plus 2pq plus q squared, and all this equals to 1. So let me explain this formula. So f here stands for the frequency of the three genotypes, which in this formula represented by p squared, 2pq and q squared, and three genotypes would be, for example, if we would have two alleles in population, allele P and allele Q. Once again, these two alleles would represent 100%. So you need to remember that 1 in our calculations is equal to 100%. So we do all our calculations on the scale between 0 and 1. But actually, this means the scale between 0 and 100%. So if we need to convert any numbers to percentages, we just have to multiply all our numbers by 100. And if you get used to different letters, for example, dominant allele A and recessive allele A, then in this case, P would stand for the dominant allele A, and Q would stand for the recessive allele A. And these two alleles in the population can produce three genotypes. So P squared would stand for the genotype which is homozygous dominant, 2PQ would stand for the genotype that is heterozygous, and Q squared would stand for the genotype that is homozygous recessive. If we know the frequency of this genotype here, that is homozygous recessive, that equal to 16%, we instantly can tell that these two genotypes, which represent the same phenotype, would occur with a frequency of 84%, because these two genotypes would make the same phenotype. We cannot for now tell what is the frequency of the homozygous dominant genotype and frequency of the heterozygous genotype, because these two genotypes would look absolutely phenotypically the same. But this genotype looks differently, and we can tell that these genotypes make 16%, because the phenotype is different. So in other words, we can say that 16% is equal to 0.16 on the scale, if we do calculations between 0 and 1, 16% would equal to 0.16. And frequency of this genotype then would equal to 0.84. So this is going to be the same. And now, in order to find a frequency of the Q allele or recessive allele A, for this part of the formula, everything we have to do, just take a square root of this number. So if we know that Q squared equal to 0.16, so Q squared equal to 0.16, it is easy to find Q. We just have to take a square root and we will find Q. So Q would equal to 0.4. So the frequency of the Q allele is 0.4, or as you understand, 40%. And it is now easier to find frequency of the P allele or dominant allele A. It is very easy. So as you see, this is going to be 0.6 and 0.6. So this is simple math. And now we can find the frequency of the heterozygous genotype, because now we have all the numbers. So frequency of the heterozygous genotype would equal to, once again, we have 2PQ, which stands for the frequency of the heterozygous genotype. And now we can use numbers that we got earlier. So would equal to 2 multiplied by 0.6 and multiplied by 0.4. So 0.6 multiplied by 0.4 would be 0.24, and multiplied by 2 would be 0.48. So this is going to be our answer, 0.48. And if you need an answer in percentage form, we have to multiply by 100. And the answer would be 48%. And as you see, this is answer B. And of course, now it is would be very easy for us to find the frequency of the homozygous dominant genotype if we know frequency of the homozygous recessive. If we know the frequency of the heterozygous genotype, we can easily find frequency of the homozygous dominant genotype, whether by subtracting from 1 these two numbers. Or we also can say that frequency of this genotype would equal to 0.6 in a power of 2, which is 0.36 or 36% frequency of this genotype. So 36, 48 and 16%. And this is all for today. Thank you for your attention. Please subscribe for my new videos that I post almost every day. Thumbs up if you like this video. Please write your comments, questions if you have any. Share this video with your classmates, and see you in the next video. Goodbye.